Well done. I'm so pleased. Now, here is the truth, good ladies. What I have just done is taught the men of your household how to bow to the queen
yes,
of your household.
That's right.
Making black eyes. Well done. Absolutely. Well, I would say that you have learned everything that you need to know about greeting.
What has the call and response?
There's one more thing that I think you need to learn. I think you better teach that.
You're going to let me do it?
I think you should. You remembered.
Oh, thank you, lady. Most lovely. All right. So, when the king and queen come, you're going to hear someone say, "Long live the king and God save the queen." It's a sign of respect. And our job is to repeat that without the end. All right, so let's pretend the king and queen came. And I said, "Long live the king and God save the queen."
Long live the king and God save the queen.
Well, my dear, well, it's Saturday morning, and I'm certain that their Friday night was quite merry. Perhaps the coffee is not kicked in.
Yeah, we need a beer.
I think you can do more! Yes! I think you can transport
more! All right, once more with some umph! Long live the king and God save the queen!
Long live the king and God save the queen!
I am basking in the gloriousness that is wonderful. I believe this day should not be a nightmare after all.
Oh, nay, my lady, I can assure thee thou art fully awake.
Shepherd, I do not mean it was actually a nightmare.
Oh, I see. Another simile.
Well, actually, Sheriff, more of a metaphor.
A metaphor? Watchman, what on earth is a metaphor?
It's where you put the horses, Sheriff.
It's where you put the horses? That confuses me further.
Oh. Sheriff, never mind. I'm certain that all will be glorious in the Well... You know, Sheriff, on this wondrous day when the king and the queen are here, and we have you and the watchman, there are others that we need to help with us, to help with security.
We do.
Absolutely. Yes. Now, you on this glorious day, I see it with the king back here. Let me see your muscles. Yes, you are saying it, you. Show me your muscles. Muscles. Well done. Now, on this day, at 2:00, we shall have on the chessboard behind, I'm training the most stalwart warriors, the most vicious, the most courageous. You see your muscles? I'm training the children of the Shire at 2:00. Come and meet us, all right? And we shall train you to be warriors. We have swords. We have fancy horses. We have lances. Be there, absolutely. Glorious well. This will be a perfect day.
They're coming, the king and the queen. They're coming right now, and I have to tell you.
Oh my God! They're coming!
Rise you up and greet you now, His Most Glorious Majesty, King of England and France, Lord of Ireland and Defender of the Faith, King Henry VIII, and his Queen, Catherine of Aragon. Long live the King, and God save the Queen!
Long live the King, and God save the Queen!
And God save you all, good people! It gladdens us greatly to see you all gathered on this, the day of our coronation. We have heard tell that Mount Hope has known the kingdom over for the qualities of its celebrations, and by God, We intend to put that to the test. What say you, Captain?
We believe your people are indeed glad to greet you, my king. They stand at the ready for your work.
Splendid!
They stand at the ready.
Oh, of course, please make yourselves comfortable, good people.
Your Majesty! Oh, oh, there you are! Your Majesty! Your Majesty! Your Majesty! It is with great pleasure that I welcome you to the Shire of Mount Hope.
Well, it is the greatest honor to be here, Lady Mayor, and we are most happy to bestow it upon thee and thy town. And this is a fine welcome indeed. Although, there seems to be something a bit off with your banner.
Oh, Your Majesty, why, tis truly by design, Your Majesty, truly, the banner, Your Majesty, is meant to... Your Majesty, the banner is meant to Your Majesty, the banner is meant to represent the weight and the... Your Majesty! The banner is meant to represent how your reign will turn the world upside down!
Well, how clever! Catherine, look. The banner is a metaphor.
I hope that's a metaphor.
God bless you, Your Majesty.
Good people of Mount Hope, from what we have seen of this village thus far, it promises indeed to be celebration most merry. I say it was rather kind of you to await upon our arrival, although had we missed even a moment of the celebrations, by God, heads would roll. But now we have arrived, we see no reason to delay things any further. Lady Man, summon something impressive and entertaining.
A moment. Henry, there are matters of court protocol that must needs be attended to.
A pox on protocol, Catherine.
Why stand on ceremony when there is revelry afoot?
You asked for my counsel on matters of the court, so I have given my counsel, but of course, it is your decision, my king.
Very well. We shall perform all of the appropriate court ceremonies in a moment. First, we would have some small entertainment. Aye, Lady Mac, give us but a taste of what splendors your village holds.
Oh, Your Majesty, with great pleasure, an appetizer, a teaser, and a moose bouche, if you will. Your Majesty, I give you Sir Isaac Fox!
Our humble village, Your Majesty.
Thank you.
Yeah, it gives me great pleasure for you to be here today. I remember when I was just a 20-year-old, and your father, your father was around, and yeah, it's getting old, really, Your Majesty. But it doesn't happen overnight. No, Your Majesty, getting old. You'll find us out, Your Majesty. You'll be standing having someone shave you in front of the mirror every morning, and finally one day you'll look in the mirror and you'll go, Dad? Oh, yeah. I'm actually beyond that point. I'm to the point now, Your Majesty, where people are showing up at my front door trying to sell me prepaid funeral packages. No, really? I had a guy show up and gave me this whole presentation thing. This is it right here. This is the whole presentation. Yeah, he said this is our deluxe model. He said what this is. He said this is Italian, hand carved Italian marble, and the drapes, he said, are French velvet, and the wood, he said, is hand rubbed wood from the Black Forest in Germany. I said that's impressive. How much? He said 24,000 pounds, and I went, I can't afford that. I'm not the king. I can't afford anything close. He said, well, you can cut it back a little. You can get rid of the marble. You'd save money. He said, you still get those French drapes and that hand rub wood. I said, okay, that's better. How much? He said, 12,000 pounds. Your Majesty, that's still way too much for me. So I told him, I said, that's too much. He said, well, we do have the economy model. He said, you get rid of the drapes, you still get that hand rub wood from the black forest in Germany. I said, much better. How much? He said, 7,000 pounds. Yeah, it was too much for me. It was. I said, sir, you don't understand. I can't afford that. He said, well, what do you do for a living? I said, well, I am a magician. And I have four shows today upon the MacGuffin stable stage at 12 o'clock, 1 and 30, 3:30, and 5 o'clock. And he said, oh, you're a magician. He said, I've got the perfect thing for you. So kids, if you see one of these on the street in a couple of years, don't kick it, all right? I might be in it. Yeah. Well, Your Majesty, I'll let you get on with those heavy-duty matters of state. And I'm gonna go shine my tan.
And now, as our good Queen Catherine has noted, the time has come for the ceremonies of state. Edward Stafford, our good Duke of Buckingham,
Your Majesty,
I prithee call forth our numerous luminaries and have them be presented to our court. As you wish. What do you mean by that, as you wish?
Because you wished it, you get it. Almost like I'm a genie.
I got a few titters out there. They laughed a little bit.
They would laugh even more if I told them that my friend Oscar was buried in one of those. If you don't know where it is, some of these people could tell you how to get there.
Lords and ladies, announcing the Royal Chronicler, Edward Hall.
Our Royal Chronicler. Today promises to be a day long remembered in history. Therefore, we command thee, see that you write down every wondrous occurrence this day, down to the smallest detail.
Oh, not a single event shall escape my eye, Your Majesty, nor shall the smallest utterance escape my ear. My dutiful quill shall record everything that transpires.
Wait, everything?
Everything, Your Majesty.
Such attention may be unwise, my king. Monarchs must often protect their nation through necessary acts that the people would not understand should they become known.
Yes, but a true king who works in service to his nation does God's work. And God's work, whether it be scrutinized by prince or by peasant, will ever show itself to be good and just.
Well said, Henry.
Buckingham!
Your Majesty!
Proceed!
As you wish.
Well done.
It's almost like I practiced.
Neither were we.
And yes, I haven't, because I believe it's spontaneity. Let me see. Lady Elizabeth Stafford. She's my sister, though she'll never admit it in public. Lady Anne Stafford. She's our sister, although we would never admit it in public. Sir Henry Courtenay.
Uh-huh.
Quit milking the bar. Sir Tarrant Unwin III. Imitation is the highest form of flattery. Sir Charles Brandon and Sir Edward Neville.
Edward! Charles!
We know you well. And we are right glad that you will be joining us in revelry this day.
Of course.
Oh, Charles.
Your Majesty. Brendan and I would not miss this day for all of the world.
Yes, it shall be a grand coronation.
Yes, the tedious ceremony. We are here for the real sort of celebrating. We do intend to divert ourselves, as you know, with every form of entertainment that this village has to offer.
Yes. And we have every maiden as well.
Yes, well, of course, that last you must enjoy without us, dear friends. We are now a married man, boys, and right happily, too. Why, if Henry Tudor is to love only one woman, then let it be the woman possessed of more grace and beauty than any other in England, or Spain,
all the wide world beside.
You flatter me, Henry.
I flatter thee indeed, Captain. Is it working?
Perhaps. Time will tell.
Buckingham, Your Majesty! Have we anyone else? Allow me to consult. It was a twist. Oh my! Edmund de la Pole, Duke of Suffolk. Greetings, my most royal king. And allow me to extend the congratulations of all the House of York on your coronation.
Suffolk, we did not think to see thee this day.
Wherefore not, my liege? I should shame myself were I to miss such an event.
Well, we are grateful indeed to have thy company. Thou wilt be the first of the York line to attend a Tudor coronation.
Aye, your majesty, and such a regret that is. I have no doubt that my uncle Richard would have gladly attended your father's coronation, had Henry not already slain him in Bath.
Deeds that were done in years long past are best left there, Suffolk.
Of course, your majesty. Queen Catherine, you are as radiant as ever.
Oh, can't you say so, Suffolk?
Allow me to give my congratulations to you as well, and to personally offer my condolences on the loss of your previous husband, Arthur.
As I said, thou art, can't you say so?
I knew your brother well, your majesty. A great man who would have made a great king. Of course, we are blessed to have yourself upon the throne. I have no doubt you shall prove to be no less grand a monarch.
We loved our brother well, Suffolk. And in this, our loss is England's loss. Nevertheless, we shall strive to be as fitting a monarch for this land as he would have been, no matter how high he may have set the bar.
But of course, your majesty, and I am certain that you shall prove equal to the challenge. Of course, Arthur was trained in affairs of state since birth, which did give him an advantage. I recall many a fond game of chess where he and I would match wits and strategy and tactics. Though I understand tennis is more
than would be most unwise to underestimate my skills, Suffolk.
Humblest apologies, your majesty. I meant no such thing. Surely your mind is no less keen than your brother's before you.
Aye, that it is, and we shall prove it, too. Lady man, if I'm correct, there is to be a game of human chess this day, aye?
Now, your majesty, at 4 o'clock.
Well then, Suffolk, it shall be our pleasure to challenge thee to this game and demonstrate to you just what sort of strategy we possess.
You honor me with such an invitation. I humbly accept.
Until then, be gone. We wish not to lay sight on thee until we meet upon the board this day.
Henry, it is an ill thing to let him rate thee so. Any man who should speak so boldly to the king should face a graver punishment.
Yes. Oh, aye, as king, we could throw him in the tower, Catherine. But as Henry, I would still bear the insult to my honor. Nay, we shall prove to that upstart pretender that both man and monarch are his superior, and send him back to Southwark with his tail between his legs! Woo! But enough of such unpleasantries, good people! We are here for celebration, are we not?
Aye!
Then let us brook no more delay! Come noontide, I shall have a great haunch of turkey in one hand and a flagon of ale in the other. Come now, my queen, and let us revel with great merriment this day.
All rise! Long live the king, and God save the queen!
Long live the king, and God save the queen!